it's coming. We always wear a little prayer shawl. This shows our constant devotion to God. You may ask, how did this tradition get started? I'll tell you. I don't know. But it's a tradition. And here, because of our traditions, everyone knows who he is and what God expects him to do.
It's all right. may it rest in peace. Couldn't give me children. Believe me, he was as good as gold. Never raised his voice for me. But other than that, he was not much of a man. So what good is it if he never raised his voice? But he was complaining. Other women enjoy complaining, but not Yenta. Not every woman in the world is a Yenta. Well, I must prepare my full set of tables. So goodbye, Golda, and it was a pleasure to
fly. Well, Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Oh, I'm losing my head. Someday it will fall up altogether, and the horse will kick it into the mud. And goodbye, Yenta. Of course, the news, it's about Blazer Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man. And I don't have to tell you that he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. You understand? Of course you do. To make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eye on Zaito.
My Zaito?
No, the Tsar Zaito. Of course, your Zaito.
Such a match for my Zaito. But Tammy wants to learn it, man. He doesn't like me.
Listen to me, Golda. Send Tammy to him. Don't tell him what it's about. He'll later discuss it himself. He'll win him over. He's a good man. A wealthy man, true?
True.
So you'll tell me how it went, Golden. You don't have to thank me, but it's aside from my fee, which anyway Laser will pay. It gives me satisfaction to make people happy. Well, what better satisfaction is there? So, goodbye, Golden. You're welcome.
Wait.
say. Let's see. What kind of mischief can I play on my friend Tabby?
So, you're finally here, my breadwinner.
You talk late.
Where's your horse?
He was invited to the blacksmith's for Saturday.
Well, hurry up. The sun won't wait for you. I have something to say to you.
The good book says, heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. In other words, send us the cure. We caught the sickness already.
Don't put on complaining, of course. After all, with your help,
I'm starving to death.
You made many, many poor people. I realize, of course, it's no shame to be poor.
It's no great honor either.
So what would have been so terrible?
I were to have a small fortune. If I were a rich man, if I were a wealthy man, I couldn't have worked hard. If I were a pity pity rich, I would need no time.
abused or evicted, forced to leave their home.
For what reason?
It doesn't say. Maybe the czar wanted that land, maybe a plague.
Well, maybe the czar had his own personal plague.
Amen!
Good! Why don't you ever bring us some good news?
I only read it. It was an edict from the authority.
May the authorities start itching in places they can't reach.
Amen!
Good!
Why do you curse then? Well, what good does your cursing do? You all stand around and curse and chatter, but you don't do anything. You all chatter your way into the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
Where are you from?
Kiev. I was a student at the university there.
Ah, the university. Is that what you learned to criticize your elders this way?
That's when I learned that there is more to life than talk. You should know what's going on in the outside world.
Why should I break my head about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
He's right. As the good book says, if you spit in the air, it lands in your face.
That's nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He's right.
He's right! He's right! How can that not be right?
You know, you are also right.
He's right. He's still right behind you. Good Sabbath, Kevia.
Good Sabbath, Kevia.
Kevia, the rabbi's orders?
Of course. So you're from Kiev, Rev.
The Perchik.
Perchik. You're a newcomer here.
As Abraham once said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
That was Moses.
Forgive me. As King David once put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
Well, a man with a slow tongue, he talked a lot.
And the chains?
Like a piece of cheese, Kevin.
I have no money, and I am not a beggar.
It is a blessing for me to give.
Very well, for your sake.
Thank you. No, it's no crime to be poor.
In this world, it is the rich who are the criminals. Well, someday, their wealth will be ours.
That would be nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
Who would make this world before the pass?
Well, people. Ordinary people.
Like you?
Like me.
Nonsense!
I don't do your golden day comes. How are you living?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have children?
I have five daughters.
Five?
Daughters.
Well, girls should learn too. Girls are people.
He's a radical!
I would be willing to teach them. Well, open their minds to great thoughts.
What great thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our times.
A very poor man has purchased, shall we say, food for us? Good. Stay the Sabbath. We don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, when a poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
When does the good book say that?
Well, it doesn't exactly say that, but somewhere, someplace, it has something about a chicken. Good Sabbath!
Good Sabbath, Timmy.
Good Sabbath!
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
the rich she gets from me.
That's the good folks say.
Stop talking right here.
The song she gets from her father.
Thank you. won't insult you by saying no.
So, how goes it with you, Devian?
How should it go?
You're right.
And you?
The same.
I'm sorry to hear that.
So, how's your brother-in-law in America?
I believe he's doing quite well.
He wronged you?
Not lately.
Then how do you know?
If he was doing badly, he was right.
Devian, I suppose you know why I wouldn't talk to you.
Yes, I do, Levin. But that is no use talking about.
Well, why not?
Why, yes. Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you'll have a few more without her.
Oh, I see. Today you want one, tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What could I do with two?
The same as you do with one.
Devian, this is very important to me.
Why is this so important to me?
Frankly, because I'm
lonesome. Lonesome?
What are you talking about?
You don't know? You are talking about my new milk cow, the one you want to buy from me.
A milk cow?
So I won't be lonesome.
What is so fun?
I was talking about your daughter, Zeitel.
My daughter, Zeitel?
Yes, Devian. I see her in my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made a very good impression on me. I like her. And as for me, Devian, I'm pretty well off. I have my own house, a servant, a shop. Look, Devian, why do we have to try to impress each other? Let's just shake hands and call it a march. And you won't need a dowry from her. Maybe you'll find something in your own purse, too.
Shame! Shame on you! My daughter's eye was not the type that I would sell for money.
All right, just as you say, we won't talk about money. The main thing is, let's quit it, Tom. I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? I never liked him. Why should I?
You can have a fine conversation with a man. You can talk about kidneys and livers.
On the other hand, not everyone has to be a scholar. If you are rich, no one will call you stupid.
With a butcher, my daughter will surely never know hunger.
He has a problem, though. He's much older than her.
No. That's her problem. She's much younger than him, and that's his problem.
I always thought of him as a butcher. But I misjudged him. He's a good man. He likes it. He'll try to make her happy.
What do I think? I call it a match.
Oh, come on, that's wonderful. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you.
No, my friend, to you.
To the both of us. To our agreement, to our prosperity, to our good health and happiness, but most of all, to life, Lehayim, 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 to life. As to the father I try to be,
is to my try to be.
Bring Lehayim, to life, Lehayim, 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 to life. Life has a way of confusing us,
blessing and bruising us.
Think like I am to lie. God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lay panting on the floor.
How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for?
Oh! to tell you, as a friend.
Yes, Your Honor.
And I'm giving you this news because I like you. You're a decent, honest person, even though you are a Jewish dog.
Thank you, Your Honor. How often does a man give a compliment like that? And your news?
We have received orders that sometime soon this district is to have a little unofficial demonstration.
A program? Here?
No, no. Just a little unofficial demonstration.
Oh, okay.
Not too serious. Just a mischief so that if an inspector should come through, he will see that we have done our duty. Personally, I don't know why there has to be this trouble between people. But I thought I should tell you and you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor.
You are a good man.
If I may say so, it's too bad you are not a Jew.
That's what I like about you, Jerry. You're always joking. And congratulations again for your doctor.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good night. Dear God, you have to bring me such news.
Nay, I'm all dead. I realize we are your chosen people. But once in a while, couldn't you
choose someone else? Anyway, thank you for bringing a husband for my life.
They even hold hands together. They even dance.
got to say, Zay?
What can she say? My firstborn, a bride. May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like that first wife of his, Ruma Sarah.
She was a bitter woman.
May she rest in peace. Not like my Zaydel. And now I must say yes, sir. My Zaydel and Ruma!
Congratulations, Idol. You are getting a rich man.
Again with the rich. What's wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. Money is the world's curse.
They go fight me with it. They'll never recover.
My side knows I've been only her welfare. My right side.
Yes, Papa.
See. I see. I see very well.
My child, why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with his blessing? What's wrong?
What's the matter?
I can't marry him. I don't want to marry him. I can't.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
Where does it stop?
cannot get worse for him.
They can only get better.
They gave each other a pledge.
Hell,
I'm sad.
They gave each other a pledge. Unthinkable.
But look at my daughter's face. She loves him. She wants him.
In my daughter's eyes. Shall we make the wedding?
Oh, thank you, Papa!
Thank you, that Jimmy! You won't be sorry!
I won't be sorry! I'm sorry already!
Thank you, Papa!
Thank you, Papa!
Thank you, Papa! Father and children, they pledge their troth. What am I going to tell Golda? What am I going to do about Golda?
Bye.
talk to you?
I'd rather not.
I've often noticed you at the bookseller's. Well, not many girls in this village like to read. Would you like to borrow this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why, because I'm not Jewish? Do you feel about us the way they feel about you? Well, I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Let me tell you about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow. Charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
I often do things I shouldn't. Go ahead, take the book. It's about Heinrich Heine. Happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
You're quite right. Good. After you return it, we'll talk about it for a while.
like to present to the newlyweds themselves. Come, Red Dog.
Like he said, I have no ill feelings. What's done is done. I'm giving the newlyweds 5 chickens. One for each of the first 5 Sabbaths of their wedded life.
Dancing, dancing, dancing was not exactly forbidden.
Rebel Village. Two on play. Play. All right, men.
Of course.
No.
they work very hard.
They're as poor as synagogue mice. They are so happy together that they do not realize how miserable they really are. Bobo keeps talking about the sewing machine. I know you are very busy with wars, revolutions, floods, plagues, all those little things that bring people to you. But could you take time away from your catastrophes and get it for you? How much trouble would it be? Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse is left leg and... Am I bothering you? I'm sorry. As the good book says...
Why should I tell you what the good book says?
Very happy.
So am I, Pritchett.
right away.
I'm sorry to hear that, Hurt. We will all miss you.
But I also have some good news. You can congratulate me.
Congratulations!
We're engaged.
Engaged?
Yes, Papa, engaged!
No, no, you are not! I know that you like him, and he likes you. But you are going away. You are staying here. So you go in peace, and my answer is no. My permission to fall inside it, so you also feel that you have a right.
I'm sorry, Christian. I like you. But you're going away.
So go and be healthy and be happy, and my answer is still no.
Please, Papa, you don't understand.
You are not listening. I say no.
I'm sorry. But we will find someone else for you. Here.
In Anatev.
Greg Tanya.
What is it?
We're not asking for your permission, only for your blessing. We are going to get married.
Not asking my permission?
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my own ears.
My blessing? For what?
For going over my head. Impossible.
At least with all my sight, they ask, they beg. But now if I like it or not, she'll marry him.
So what do you want from me?
Go on, beware.
And tear off my beard and uncover my head. For a shot, they're not even asking permission from their papa.
What's happening to the tradition? Lie, my blood of red. Where has it led? To this?
A man tells me he's marrying my daughter. He does not ask me. He tells me. But first, he abandons.
He's not abandoning me, Papa.
As soon as I can, I will send for her and marry her. I love her.
Love me.
Do I what?
Oh. Do you
not my father and my mother said we learned to love each other. So now I'm asking, both of you, do you love me?
I'm your wife!
I know.
Dancing.
peace in a settlement in Siberia.
Siberia? He asked you to leave your family and join him there in that frozen wasteland and marry him there.
No, Papa, he's not asking me to go. I want to go. I don't want him to be alone. I want to help him in his work. The greatest work in man can do, Papa.
But hold on.
Thank you.
you and he would be, remain friends from a distance.
You must never forget who you are.
Who that man is.
He has a name, Papa.
Of course.
All creatures on Earth have names.
Yepkin's not a creature, Papa. Yepkin's a man.
Who says that he isn't? It's just a different kind of man. As the good book says, each shall seek his own kind. Which translated means, a bird may love a fish, but where would they make a home together?
The world is changing, Papa!
No! Some things do not change for us. Some things never change.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Yetka and I. We want to be married.
Married? Do you understand what that means to marry outside of the faith? Never mention his name again! Do you understand me?
Yes, Papa, I understand. Oh, good, you're here. Let's go home. It's time for supper.
I want to see Mokul's new machine.
You can see him some other time. It's late.
Quiet, woman! You'll make me angry. When I get angry, the flies don't dare fly.
Very right, Toby. After supper, I'll faint. Come home!
Go. I am the man of the house. I am the head of the family, and I demand to see Morton's new machine now! Now we can go home!
Such a sweet little bird you were, Harlan. Thank you.
mob. He's a person.
The Pablo and Thurchuk. When will we ever see them?
Well, do they come visit us every Sabbath? No, you know what she writes. He sits in prison, she works. Soon he will be out, and together they will turn the world upside down. They couldn't be happier. And the other children, they will be with us.
Not all.
All. Come, Logan, we have to be finished.
I still have to sweep the floor.
Sweep the floor?
I don't want to leave a dirty house.
Well, Debbie, I'm on my way.
Where are you going?
Chicago. My wife, Truma Serra, may she rest in peace, has a brother there.
That's nice.
I hate him, but a relative is a relative. Goodbye, Debbie.
Bye.
Yes, we are also moving. Some are driven away by edicts, others by silence. Come on.